Good morning, students. This is our second lecture of chapter 2, Kings, Farmers and Town. Today we discuss topic 3 and 4 of this chapter. For this discussion, you have to open page number 32 of your book where you got these topics. Topic 3, an early empire. The growth of Magadha culminated in the emergence of the Mauryan Empire. Chandragupta Maurya, who founded the empire, extended his control as far northwest as Afghanistan and Balochistan, and his grandson Ashoka, arguably the most famous ruler of early India, conquered Kalinga, present-day coastal Orissa. If we talk about the sources of Mauryan Empire, then account of Megasthenes called Indica, actually Megasthenes is a Greek ambassador to the court of Chandragupta Maurya. Arthashastra probably composed by Kautilya or Chanakya, the minister of Chandragupta, later Buddhist, Jaina and Puranic literature, besides the inscriptions of Ashoka on rocks and pillars, are often regarded as amongst the most valuable sources for getting the information of Mauryan Empire. Dhamma. Ashoka used the inscription to proclaim what he understood to be Dhamma, which included respect towards elder, generosity towards Brahmanas and those who renounced worldly life, treating slaves and servants kindly, and respect for religions and tradition other than one's own. According to him, this would ensure the well-being of people in this world. Special officers known as Dhamma Mahamatas were appointed to spread the message of Dhamma. If we talk about the administrating centers of Mauryan Empire, there were 5 major political centers in the empire. The capital Pataliputra and the provincial centers of Taxila, Ujjaini, Tosali, Suvarnanagiri are important. It is likely that administrative control was strongest in areas around the capital and the provincial centers. These were wisely chosen, as both Taxila and Ujjaini, being situated on important long distance trade routes, while Suvarnagiri was possibly important for tapping the gold mines of Karnataka. It was also known as the Golden Mountain of the Empire. Communication along both land and riverine routes was vital for the existence of the empire. Megasthenes mentioned a committee with 6 sub-committees for coordinating military activity. In the 19th century, the emergence of the Mauryan Empire was regarded as a major landmark, as India was under colonial rule during that time. Some of the archaeological finds associated with the Mauryas, including stone sculpture, were considered to be example of spectacular art typical of empires. Nationalist leaders in the 20th century regarded Ashoka as an inspiring figure, as the inscription suggested that was more powerful and industrious, as also more humble than later rulers who adopted grandiose titles. New notions of kingship. By the 2nd century BCE, new chiefdoms and kingdoms emerged in several parts of the subcontinent. This development was mainly seen in the Deccan and further south, including the chiefdoms of the Cholas, Cheras and Pandyas in Tamilakam, proved to be stable and prosperous. The name of ancient Tamil country, which included parts of present-day Andhra Pradesh and Kerala in addition to Tamil Nadu. Many chiefs and kings, including Satvahanas, who ruled over part of western and central India, and the Shakas, a people of Central Asian origin who established kingdoms in the northwestern and western parts of the subcontinent, derived revenues from long-distance trade. Divine kings. other means of claiming high status was to identify with a variety of deities the Kushanas who ruled over a vast kingdom extending from Central Asia to Northwest India followed this strategy. They adopted the title Devaputra or son of God, installed colossal status in the shrines. By the 4th century, there is evidence of larger states including the Gupta Empire. These states depended on Samanthas, men who maintained themselves through local resources including control over the land. The Pragya Prashasti, also known as the Allahabad Pillar inscription, composed in Sanskrit by Harisena, the court poet of Samudragupta, arguably the most powerful of the Gupta rulers. Students, in the next lecture, we will discuss the topic 5 and 6 of the same chapter. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe. Try to make a nice day. Goodbye.